This episode of Tekzilla is brought to you by domain.com.
Need to run another operating system? Only have one machine? Just don't want to switch machines to run a little fast code? You need to learn about virtual machines, software emulations of computers. They're not just for developers and sysadmins. And Shannon is all over it.
That's right, I am. Just like when I have a cake and I want to eat it.
You are all over it. Like with Shannon on cake. Oh, I'm going to get in trouble for that one later on.
So recently I ran into this huge problem where I needed to run an operating system called Kali Linux on my Windows 8 machine. So sure, I could just dual boot them or I could VNC into a Kali Linux PC somewhere, but I just wanted to run it for some quick uses. So I didn't want another physical computer. That would be too expensive. Enter VMware Player with Linux, which is a lot easier than it sounds.
It's a game, right?
So VMware Player, it's free to download over at my.vmware.com. So once you download it, you just open it. So I have it pre-installed on my computer. You just open it from the menu, and then you can create a virtual machine, or you can open a new virtual machine. So for me, I had to create this one called Kali Linux. It was already compiled into a VM version, and you can find that over at theoffensivesecurity.com website. They already created a version that works, so I just downloaded that one from them, VMware image down here. Another really cool thing is if you don't already have the image pre-installed or pre-made by somebody else, you can always just download an ISO and create a new virtual machine by just choosing the ISO image and creating it that way. But since I already have it compiled, I can just click on Kali Linux and choose Play Virtual Machine. So Kali Linux is a really fun hacker-esque type operating system if you ever want to check it out. It has a bunch of built-in security tools, everything from like Netcat and Nmap, Wireshark, Metasploit, all those ones that everybody's heard of. And when you're in a virtual machine, the cool thing about VMware Player is you can click in between your operating systems. You can do whatever work needs to be done, and hooray for multitasking. It's super easy.
I mean, I should point out, like they call it sandboxing. The operating system is sandboxed and isolated from your main operating system. But what that really means is there's a giant flaming wall of doom and mayhem surrounding all of those scary tools.
Yay! I mean,
well, yeah, it sounds, but people are like, well, isn't that dangerous? Well, no, driving on the highway is dangerous. Running a virtual machine is actually pretty manageable.
It's very manageable, and it runs just fine on my laptop, which is something great about it. It's very lightweight, so you can run it on any machine pretty much. Another tool that I wanted to mention also is called Cygwin. So this is very useful if you aren't so familiar with the Windows command line commands and options, and you would rather just use Linux commands when you're working on your Windows machine. So this isn't necessarily running Linux on your Windows computer like VMware Player is, but it's for the command line system. So you can go over to cygwin.com, and it looks like it's from the 90s, but it definitely works. You install the version for your system, whether it's 32 or 64-bit. When it's done, you just open up the .exe setup file like you would any other. And Cygwin looks like a command line, which is pretty cool.
It looks like Bash.
It does, yeah. So it's incredibly similar to using a Bash interface on Linux by just starting a program from your desktop. So you can try some commands, like I could put in pwd, and I find out I'm in home Shannon. I could do ls to see what's in my Shannon directory. I have a couple of text documents in there. I could even do, and this is pretty cool too, I can still run Windows commands on here as well.
Cool.
So I can do multiple commands depending on which ones I know. And anytime you open up that setup exe file, you can install extra packages that you can use. So you can use everything that you would normally use in a Linux environment. So say you want to install gedit or netcat or something like that, you can run all those too in Cygwin, which makes it super, super reliable and very easy to learn both ways
we
of doing
like
things.
Super reliable and super
it's
easy.
It's very fun.
It's kind of funny. If you go to the Wikipedia entry on virtual machines, there's like, I don't know, three dozen.
There's a lot
of these, but a couple that are probably worth mentioning the most are Parallels at parallels.com and the free but somewhat less sophisticated VirtualBox at virtualbox.org. Hey, if you're doing something really cool with virtual machines, post about it on our Facebook page or Google Plus page or email Tekzilla@revision3.com. We will share it with the Tekzilla crew. Sharing is caring.
Sharing is caring, and there's a lot more sharing coming right up. But before we do that, it's time to thank one of our sponsors. Do you want to upgrade your skill set, but you can't afford the time and money that you need for a traditional learning environment? Well, don't worry. You can learn it at LYNDA.com, the online learning company with thousands of video tutorials that teach software, creative, and business skills. Plus, new courses are added every single week, and the training library keeps pace with today's fast-changing technical and software skills. You can learn anytime, anywhere, at your own pace, from bite-sized tutorials to comprehensive courses in motion graphics and programming, web design, and there's so much more. Memberships start at $25 per month, and they provide unlimited 24/7 access to top-quality video courses taught by expert instructors with real-world experience. So try LYNDA.com free for 7 days by visiting LYNDA.com/Tekzilla and get the skills you need to get ahead.